Hello everyone, this is Happy Nian. On October 12th at the COP15 in Kunming, China, China took the lead in establishing the Kunming Biodiversity Fund with 1.5 billion yuan and setting up the first batch national parks, including Sanjiangyuan National Park, Wuyi Mountain National Park, Jingpanda National Park, Northeast China Tiger and Leopard National Park, and Hainan Tropical Rainforest National Park, issuing a call to the world to protect biodiversity.
I'm getting fat again.
Well, well, well. I heard your journey to Sichuan banana is quite fancy.
You don't say. Bananas on the corners all the way.
But I just need to line my back. Millions of people will watch me eating online. I'm superstar queen, you know.
What a cutie pie I am.
Hey, tiger mate. I heard there's a national park at your place. What could we hang on there?
Welcome you all come to Northeast China. Except in cold weather, everything is great.Remember to bring your thermal underwear though.
Let's go!
Wait!
From the downgrading of Jingpandas this year to escorting the migration of Asia elephants along the way, China's achievements in ecological protection have been widely approved by international community. The Wall Street Journal reported on 11 October that in the past 20 years, tigers in China's northeastern have gone from being functionally extinct to a population of 55 today.The WWF and the Wildlife Conservation Society said this was a dramatic recovery and a rare success story. AP reported on 12 October that after decades of rapid economic growth, China has made progress in recent years in protecting plant and animal habitats and wildlife. China has established natural reserves, which have allowed populations of species such as Jingpanda to recover. CBD Executive Secretary Elizabeth Manura said in an interview that China is a strong supporter and contributor to global biodiversity conservation. The concept of ecological civilization came by China is crucial for countries to reach the global biodiversity targets, and its work in promoting harmonious coexistence between humans and nature is worth learning from.Reuters report on 8 October that the world expects that COP15 can actually achieve its biodiversity conservation goals. Greenpeace praised China's decision to set up national parks, saying that countries' establishment of natural reserves would help it take the lead in achieving its goal of protecting at least 30% of its land by 2030. Okay, this is Happy Nian. See you next time!